everyone, and welcome to Norwich High School's Class of 2020 Commencement Exercises. It's nice and cool, but hey, harvest is over, the yields were good, and we've got 25 fantastic reasons to be here today. Maybe it was 26, sorry about that. It is my pleasure to introduce this evening's guests that are joining me on the stage, USD 331 Superintendent Max Clark, Board of Education members Jeff Samuelson, President, Tab Turner, Vice President, Christy Brown, Leslie Crable, Angie Maloney, Erica Parsons, and also Heidi Howard, Norwich School Administrator. At this time, USD 331 Superintendent Max Clark will address our graduates and guests.
Two minutes, welcome. You can tell this is a well-oiled machine right now by the fact that I had to go out and turn on the tape recorder, the video recorder, because I forgot to do that. Thank you all for coming out. Really quick, Mrs. Clark, who led the parade in and did the intro, is filling in for you guys' principal, Dustin Little, Mr. Little, who's been your principal for the last 2 years. Dustin's not returning next year, as I think most of you are probably aware. He intended to be here tonight to send you guys off and serve as the MC, if you will, of your graduation. And his wife is a victim of COVID, it appears, and he's a victim of COVID by association at this moment. They're waiting to get test results, but it was deemed by the powers that be that he should not attend this event. So he wishes you the best. He's enjoyed you and the time that he got to spend with you guys. At the same time, it gives us the opportunity for Mrs. Clark to be reintroduced to you as a community and as a school, because she's going to be the 712 principal here next year. And very excited to join Mrs. Howard on the administrative team at Norwich. So thank you for that, Tammy. So, class of 2020. Congratulations on this milestone. Sorry it's a couple of months late. We were all hoping it'd be 2 months ago, but it is what it is. First of all, what an honor it is for me to have the opportunity to address you as Superintendent of Schools in the very district that I was born and raised in. I graduated from Kingman High School 44 years ago, and I sat out there like you are, listening intently on my every word. I'll be honest with you, I don't really remember who spoke at my high school graduation, and I don't really remember what his message was, but I'm sure that it was a message full of hope and inspiration. I want you to know that I left Kingman and Kingman County for 20 years before I was blessed to come home and hopefully make a difference in the educational opportunities that our young people in the district have today. I thank the communities and the current and previous school boards for the opportunities afforded me and my family. I remember at 18 years of age, I could not wait to get out of Kingman. I could not wait to get out of the town that I grew up in, because it was a boring town. Okay? After going to college and then teaching other places, coaching, becoming a principal, the opportunity to come home and have my kids develop a close relationship with their grandmother was an awesome opportunity. My point of all of this is that I urge you, 2020 graduates, to go explore a bit, but don't hesitate to come home. I hope many of you come back and settle down and raise your families and ultimately give as much back to this little town as it is given you. You know, some of us are risk takers. Some of us like to play it safe, at least until we learn more about the positives and negatives of something. Take our phones and computers, for example. When you get that notice that you need to upgrade your operating system, who out there wants to be the first one to do it? Some of you do, okay? Those new and improved operating system updates can be a real disaster, and we've all probably experienced that. Seems to really make a mess of everything on our phone or our device. And I think you all know what I'm talking about. How many of you have tried to uninstall an update? That's not usually very successful either. It's kind of like, just let me go back to the old one, would you please, please, please? Let's take January 1st of this year. You guys were just happily entering a new year. We were all entering a new decade. All you seniors were looking forward to your last few months in high school when all of a sudden, things started acting not quite right. Suffice it to say, by April, most of us were ready to uninstall 2020. Because that version truly does have a virus in it. It was destabilizing everything that we know and could count on. This thing called normal was imploding, not only in front of us, but all around us. It's been particularly difficult for many of us because it has only now begun to strike closer to home. As I see it, we've got a couple of choices. We can feel sorry for ourselves, for what we've missed out on, or we can choose to look at the positives. I'll challenge you to look at the positives, not just today's current situation with the pandemic, but from this day forward, each and every day. I feel like there's a silver lining to all of this, and I'll cite a few examples of why I feel this way. We've all been so busy living life that many of us have lost the real, genuine moments we should have with our loved ones. Maybe it was busy schedules, running to make ends meet, rushing from one practice to another practice, or one meeting to the next meeting, all of them urgent. The silver lining? Life slowed down. Slowed down for all of us. That was a positive. We found creative ways to stay connected with people. We had a great opportunity to reconnect with our families and spend some quiet time. As 17 and 18 year olds, you might not have valued that as much as your parents did, but I assure you, it was a special opportunity for families that doesn't happen as much as it should. Something as simple as sitting around the dinner table talking with no interruptions and no place to rush off to. Another thing on my silver lining list, we've improved our personal hygiene, haven't we? Being hygienic is no longer just a good habit. It's a skill. It's the very skill that you need for survival. As humans, we are innately social. That isn't going to change. We still want to be around people. We still want to connect. We still want to interact. We will continue to learn how to interact more hygienically. That's not a bad thing. I've interviewed a number of prospective teachers over the past few months, and it's been very awkward meeting these people for the first time. It's been very unnatural not to shake their hand. So that's something that we're gonna have to probably get used to. It's a tough habit to break. Some really cool and creative ways to connect to people have emerged. Finding a creative way to stave off boredom within four walls has become quite entertaining. TikTok. How many of you have TikTok? Come on. Did you know that I'm kind of a TikTok celebrity? Dad, what are you looking at me all? I know it's the sun, but I've got a video that's been viewed over almost 250,000 times. Okay, yeah. How many of you have 250, a quarter of a million under your belt? Oh, a few of you. So you're having fun, okay? I got my youngest son, he's got some that have over a million views, but I will be honest with you, the star of his TikTok videos are his two golden retrievers. Anyway, These ideas will continue to find their way into business world, I believe, creating new tools, software that has caused a shift in how business is conducted has been developed, as well as how school is conducted. I can't wait to see what's next. Remote working, remote learning, it's becoming the mainstream. In case you're wondering, we do plan to have school starting next month, and we do plan for it to be face-to-face in person, but we've got three or four contingency plans we're working on, and you're going to hear a whole lot more about that over the next couple of weeks. So, other thing, excuse me, skies are bluer, less smog. If you've gone, you haven't gone to Colorado. Most of you have stayed away from there, I hope. It's actually, Colorado is not the, doesn't have all the hot spots yet. So anyway, see a lot of people biking, walking, exercising outside. So that's pretty cool. People continually tell young people like you, you graduates, that you have your whole life in front of me. Actually, we all do. Even me, I still have what's left of my whole life in front of me. Actually, what we mean, what we're really trying to tell you, is advising you to make the most of your life. Engage and really live life. Don't be that person that sits back and watches it go by without engaging. I like to say there are two basic personalities that most people have. They're either motivated to succeed or they're motivated to avoid failure. Think about that for a minute. Wonder what that means. And which are you? Someone that's motivated to avoid failure tends to not be a risk taker. They try to do things, they don't try things that get them out of their comfort zone. Why? Because they're afraid of failure. They don't want to be afraid of failure, but they're afraid of failure nevertheless. They don't want to disappoint themselves. They don't want to disappoint others. They don't want to disappoint their parents. They don't want to get laughed at or giggled at, whatever. They don't want to take a chance. They just want to fit in. Now, someone who's motivated to succeed will take some chances. They'll try some new things, and if they fail, they learn from what went wrong. They grow from the experience and the chances they took. Scenario, two outs, the bottom of the ninth. What kind of personality wants to be the batter? How about the final seconds of a game, down by one? What kind of personality wants the ball in their hands? Is it the risk taker? And don't misunderstand me. I'm not saying that nor am I suggesting that you should engage in risky behavior that's dangerous, that could really hurt you. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you need to try new things. You need to spread your wings. If you miss that last second shot, is it the end of the world? It feels like it maybe for just a little bit, but it's really not. I challenge you to do a couple of things. Develop your own mission statement, write it down. You don't have to tell anyone. It can be deeply personal, especially as you're trying to figure out this thing called life. Your mission statement should evolve as you change your personal goals. But have a goal. Make goals. I'll give you some suggestions. Actually, it's called unsolicited advice. Successful people focus more on others than themselves. Think about that. Focus more on others than themselves. Don't compromise your character to get ahead. Remember this, nobody can take your education away from you. If you think you're done learning, you're mistaken. If you're simply prepared, you are simply prepared for the next things to learn. What that will be is up to you. Some of you are going to college, some of you are going to a technical school, some of you are going to work. Every one of those scenarios, you're going to be learning new things. Don't ever forget the excitement you felt when you were offered your first real job. Even if it doesn't turn out to be your dream job, always give 100%. You owe that to the person that hired you, to the company or the organization that you work for. Commit to being the best at whatever it is that you're doing. Whatever it is that you're getting paid to do, I can assure you that if you always show up to work with a positive attitude and are committed to working hard, Even if you don't like the job, your work will get noticed and you will rise up, and soon enough, it will be something you like or maybe even love. It will provide you with much positive inner satisfaction. If you simply cannot keep your attitude up and positive, then it's time for you to move on. And that's okay too. Don't be that person or that coworker, that colleague that is negative and grouchy. Be the one everybody says, he or she is just so positive. I promise you it will get you places. Again, don't forget the excitement when you got that call. Hey, I would like to offer you a job. Bring that excitement with you every day. I'm about done. I would be remiss if I did not at least comment to you, the class of 2020, about being participants in the longest senior skip day in history. Let us hope and pray that your record is never broken. Now I want to share a little something with you that I'd like to become maybe a little bit of a tradition, traditional thought about you that future classes might also carry. It's kind of loosely based on something many of you know as the Irish blessing. It's not plagiarized, I promise you that. I had the privilege of collaborating with Mike Justice on this. It's only fair to give Mike credit for putting this thought together, as he allowed me to make a couple of modifications. We were brainstorming on some ideas of messages to share with you as seniors, and got to thinking about the Irish blessing, and then this developed. So I hope you enjoy it. We titled it Eagles Soar, Norwich High School, Class of 2020. You began this educational journey as young eaglets, anxious and full of energy. Today, you come to the conclusion of this segment of your life's journey with wings that will allow you to soar into the future with confidence. May you always find good work for your hands to do. May the sun shine upon you to warm your days. May a rainbow be certain to follow each rain to encourage you. May the hand of a friend always be near you for help. May oftentimes you be the friend that is near to help others. May your heart be filled with gladness to cheer you. So rise up, eagles, and soar in strength and beauty. And always give thanks to the provider of the wind beneath your wings. Blessings to you, young eagles. Now go spread those wings and soar. Stay safe, positive, and don't forget where you came from. Come back and visit. Stay in touch. We are so very, very proud of you and cannot wait to watch you soar. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Clark. The Citizenship Award, an award chosen by the Norwich faculty, is given each year. This male and female student must meet the following criteria as set forth by the Kansas State High School Activities Association: respect, responsibility, and reverence. It is with great pleasure that I present this year's Citizenship Awards to Kenna Hibbs and Wyatt Zulian. Please come to the stage. This time, Mrs. Heidi Howard will share scholarships awarded to the class of 2020. All right. seniors, let's talk about scholarships. We have, first of all, Blake Allender received the Kansas State University Wildcat Tradition Scholarship, the Kansas State University Agriculture Department Scholarship, the Greg Berry Memorial Scholarship, Kansas Feed and Grain Scholarship, Kingman County 4-H Cookies for College Scholarship, Kingman County 4-H Council Scholarship, Norwich Booster Club Scholarship, Sumner Cali Electric Scholarship, Tony and Marge Burkamp Scholarship, and Whitetails Unlimited Scholarship. Lane Bryant, the WSU Tech Signing Day Scholarship. Danielle Hedrick, HCC Grant and Helen Wagner Memorial Scholarship, HCC Endowment Annual Fund Scholarship, and First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. Ethan Hedrick, WSU Tech Signing Day Scholarship, First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. Grant Hedrick, First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. JC Hedrick, Adams Union Sunday School Scholarship, CCW K Scholarship, Conway Bank Salutatorian Scholarship, Eagle Grocery Scholarship, Kroger Scholarship, Norwich High School Alumni Scholarship, Wanda Mae Vinson Scholarship, and First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. Melissa Hedrick, First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. Sean Hedrick, First Year Full Tuition Scholarship. Harper Hedrick, Butler Community College Presidential Scholarship, Norwich EMS Scholarship, and Whitetails Unlimited. Kenna Hibbs, Kansas State University Scholar Award, Farrar Corporation Valedictorian Scholarship, Better Business Bureau Student of Integrity Scholarship, Kansas All-Star Valedictorian Scholarship, Kingman Norwich KNEA Scholarship, Milton Norwich Interchurch Council Scholarship, and Norwich Booster Club Scholarship. Luke Hilger, Hutchison Dragon Scholarship Ag Diesel Award, and High Plains Farm Credit Scholarship. Oh, keep going. Kingman County Conservation Scholarship, Norwich Booster Club Scholarship, Norwich United Methodist Church Scholarship, SKP Scholarship, and Sumner Cali Electric Scholarship. Jonathan Honey, Friends University Baseball Scholarship. Brooklyn Mock, Cali County Cheer Scholarship, and Kansas All-Star Scholarship. Ethan Poe, Hutchison Community College Track Scholarship. Tori Poe, Fort Hays State University Tiger Pride Scholarship, Fort Hays State University Track Scholarship, Farrar Corporation Valedictorian Scholarship, Haviland Broadband Scholarship, Jim and Carolyn Poe Scholarship, Norwich Booster Club Scholarship, Norwich Recreation Scholarship, and Wheatland Electric Scholarship. Haley Rhodes, Fort Hays State University Black and Gold Scholarship, and Creek Nation Scholarship. Damaris Smith, Cali County Dean's Academic Scholarship, Norwich Booster Club Scholarship. Ethan Westlake, Fort Hays State University Theater Scholarship. Thank you, Mrs. Howard. Okay, our salutatorian and valedictorians will now present their messages to the graduates. And first would be our salutatorian. Our salutatorian has demonstrated excellence in academics, activities, and community. And this year's salutatorian is JC Hedrick. Come on up to the stage, JC.
Friends, faculty, and community members. Thank you all for coming. On behalf of our class, I want to give a huge thank you to those who have made today possible. We finally made it to the day that many of us had marked on our calendars for a very long time. Even though this day has finally come, it's nothing like what we imagined. Life is certainly full of surprises and things which are out of our control, but how we react is a choice. If this has taught me anything, it's that nothing is for certain. Plans may change, but opportunities arise. No matter the obstacles or adversities you face in the future, you have already proven you can overcome them. When looking back on today, remember it's about the accomplishment of graduating, not the ceremony that matters. The memories and education we now have were already worth celebrating, which neither can be taken away. What we've lost in moments and memories, we've gained in perseverance and strength. I admit it's easy to regret and focus on the would-haves, but if you take a step back and look at the amazing accomplishments and memories within these last 4 years, turn your would-haves into I-dids. Understand that we are sitting here today as a product of our work, whether that be as a go-getter or a procrastinator. Either way, you made it. As graduates, we survived high school, those dreaded Zoom meetings, and so far, a worldwide pandemic. This year, we'll never be able to define who we are. What defines us as a class is, well, us. When describing our class, we often hear the words big, loud, diverse, and most commonly, unique. The class of 2020 is definitely one that will be remembered. We're in a unique situation, but what makes us even more so is every individual sitting in those chairs. Just take a look around you. We literally cannot be put into a box. As many of you remember, before entering eighth grade, our class was so big that a wall had to be knocked down just so we could fit into the classroom. And ever since that day, we made our mark at Norwich. Ironically, today, we graduate without any walls, and unfortunately, air conditioning. So to keep it short, my last words to my class are that I encourage you all to go out and continue to break down walls and surprise us all as you each make your own mark on this world. Thank you.
Thank you, JC. I remember that wall being knocked down. Okay, now for our valedictorians. This year's graduating class was not short on success. That is reflected in the work that the valedictorians put into their educational careers. This year's valedictorians are Kenna Hibbs and Tori Poe. If you'll please come to the stage.
To try to keep this speech short, just like our senior year was. We would like to thank all of you for attending this unusual, non-traditional graduation, and we hope that you and your loved ones are and continue to be in good health. We would like to thank our families, teachers, coaches, and community for their unwavering love and support, both throughout high school and during these difficult times. We have made many wonderful memories during high school, but unforeseen circumstances led to a sudden and unfortunate ending to them, offering us little to no closure. More than a few of us probably feel a little guilty for longing for spring break. Our situation has been tough on many of us, to say the least. Personally, spring is my favorite part of the school year, and I was especially heartbroken to discover that I would not get a senior track season. My classmates and I had also looked forward to prom, senior countdown, graduation, and other various milestones marking the end of our time in high school. Unfortunately, a traditional end of the year was not in God's plan, and we had had our last day at Norwich High School without even knowing it. Instead of telling you how unfair this feels, I will tell you what we can take away from it. The kids that grew up during the Great Depression era were known as the generation that never let anything go to waste and saved all their money. They were especially appreciative of the things they had not always had. Perhaps you can be known as the generation that never lets a single ordinary day for granted. We thought we had more time than we did. There are more memories to be made, recognition to be given. We should have gotten everything that previous graduating classes got. It certainly feels that we were robbed of our time. However, that is impossible, as you can't be robbed of something that never really belonged to you in the first place. Time is not something we are entitled to. Seasons of life come and go as they please, and the only thing that we can control is how much we enjoy and appreciate the moment right in front of us. Maybe if all of this teaches us to start treating time like the gift it has always been, it will be worth it.
Writing a story or journaling about my day is way easier than writing a valedictorian speech, even when I only have to write half of it. If I were to sum up everything I've learned throughout my 18 years of life, my entire high school career, and the last few crazy months, it'd be these two things. One, life doesn't always go the way you plan. And two, time sure does fly. Tori spoke of the emotional roller coaster of being a graduating senior in the times of COVID-19. None of us could have predicted that the end of our senior year would be taken from us, but that's just what happened. It feels like just yesterday the state basketball tournament was canceled. That was 4 months ago. Since then, I finished high school, spent many nights with friends, social distancing of course, finalized college plans, packed up my room, and prepared for the day I'd finally graduate. The last few months of senior year passed by in a blur. When I think back, my 4 years of high school passed in a blur. At the time, especially as a freshman and sophomore, I felt my days went by slowly. I couldn't wait to grow up. This year, though, was gone in the blink of an eye. All my life, I've been told that time flies. I never believed it until now. All the late nights spent riding on a bus, all the games I played on a court, all the lectures, sometimes dull, during class, all the times I laughed until I was breathless, all the memories I made with old friends and new, the highs and lows of high school. I'm never gonna feel that way again, but new adventures lie ahead. It's all kind of bittersweet. To my class, I'd like to wish you all the best. Our futures are unknown, but I hope you take advantage of every opportunity given to you. To all of you still in school, soak up every moment. Whether you've got 1 year left or many, please don't take any of it for granted. One day, these years will be a distant memory. Make it good. Go out, have fun, live it up. And in everything you do, give it your all. If you take away anything from our rambling today, we hope you leave here prepared to look at life in a different light. Time is a gift that should not be taken for granted. Live your life purposefully and passionately. And my last 2 cents goes to the girls' basketball team. Claver says fouling the shooter is like kissing your brother, so don't foul the shooter. Thank you all for your time, and I hope you have a great evening.
Thank you, Kenna and Tori. All right, now for the time we've all been waiting for. Superintendent Clark, USD 331 Board of Education members, parents, family, and friends, having met all requirements set forth by the School Board of Unified School District 331, Kansas State Department of Education, and the Kansas State Board of Education, these students are entitled to their high school diplomas with the privileges, rights, and responsibilities that accompany it. Now, would the first row of graduates please stand and walk to the stage? At this time, I would like to introduce Board of Education members Tab Turner and Jeff Samuelson, who will be presenting the diplomas to the 2020 graduates. Are you checking in? Okay. Blake Dean Allender. Yeah. Kyle Brian Bradley. Lane Michael Bryant. Juliana Hope Lynn Chambers. Danielle Patrice Hedrick. Ethan Roy Hedrick. Douglas Hedrick. JC Lynette Hedrick. Melissa Sue Hedrick. Sean Edward Hedrick. Rose Hedrick. Lily Simone Heimerman. Kenna Michelle Hibbs. Second row, please stand and come to the stage. Luke Reed Hilger. Zachary Cole Loffery. Brooklyn, Rihanna Mock. Madison May Peterson. Ethan Ryan Poe. Tori Sue Poe. Eddie Thomas Ponce. Eddie Tomas Ponce. Sorry about that, Eddie. Haley Rochelle Rhodes. Damaris Rose Smith. Aaron Lee James Venata. Ethan Michael Westlake. Wyatt Justin Zulian. Graduates, please stand and face the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of Norwich High School, class of 2020. Congratulations, graduates. If you'd like to throw your caps up, this is the time, but you don't have to.
Yeah.
The excitement of 2020 just keeps going. I'd like to thank, this concludes our commencement ceremony. Thank you for coming and being a part of this special occasion with the graduates. Please, audience, please wait for the graduates to process off the football field. And I'd like to say, as this is the Norwich High School's newest alumni, you may now process off the field and to the west side of the track. Congratulations!